Hello, I'm Philip Chan, teaching fellow from the School of Accounting and Finance from the Hong Kong Polytechnic University. I'm about to show you a short lecture sessions clip of my subject, AF3111, Intermediate Accounting 2. And in this clip, I will cover the definitions of lease in accordance with the HKFRS 16 leases and its application from the perspective of the lessees. Hope you will enjoy it. Well, so what is a lease contract then? A typical rental arrangement is in between a supplier, landlord, and the customers, tenants, which would allow the customers to have the right to use an asset over a specified period of time, i.e. lease term. And in return, the customers will need to pay the supplier lease payments over that lease period. And the common question that we often ask is this arrangement follows HKFRS 16, Hong Kong Financial Reporting Standards 16? Well, by definitions of the HKFRS 16 leases, a lease is a contract that conveys the rights to control the use of an identified asset for a period of time in exchange for considerations. So we may have to look closely on two issues that are stated in the definitions. The first issue is related to the term identified assets. It was stated in the standard, an identified asset could be either implicitly or explicitly specified in the contract, and it must be physically distinct. Now in the standard, it actually gives us two examples of assets that are not physically distinct, such as a portion of an asset is not physically distinct, e.g. 60% of a pipeline's capacity would not be considered as physically distinct. And another example is free to use any of the 20 fiber optic cables is not physically distinct as well. Right, another issue that we need to consider further is, would the contract convey the right to control the use of an identified asset to the customers? How can we prove that then? Well, according to the standard, two conditions must be both fulfilling in order to claim that the customers have receiving such a right to control the use of an identified assets, such as the customers will be able to direct the use of an identified assets and be able to obtain substantially all the economic benefits from directing the use of such identified assets. Now, if we can prove that the rental or even service arrangement satisfying the definitions of lease in accordance with HKFRS 16, we can then call the supplier as the lessor and the customer as lessee. Now, both the lessor and the lessee will have to account for the lease in their financial statements in accordance with HKFRS 16. Now, we will focus on the accounting for lessee in this slides. Under HKFRS 16 leases, lessees would apply a single model for accounting of lease. Now, upon the commencement day, which is the day the lessees obtain a right to use and identify assets, the lessee should recognize an asset reflecting such rights exists and a liability for its obligation to pay rental, i.e. the lessee should recognize a right of use asset as a non-current asset and also a lease liability. Now, very often we will ask ourselves one very simple question. Is it good news or bad news for the lessees to have more assets and more liability? Well, according to the standard, the lessees will need to split the balance of the lease liability into two portions, the non-current and the current portions. Now, the non-current portion of the lease liability will then increase the debt over equity ratios. What that means is it would mean more risky in the eye of the shareholders. Okay, and also the right of use assets and the lease liability would incur depreciation and interest expenses over the lease term. Both will reduce the profitability of the companies, okay, of the lessee particularly, would reduce it. That means bad news also, right? So in conclusion, the single model accounting for lessee would bring bad news to the lessees. Okay, well, sometimes in the lease contract, the suppliers has a right to substitute identified asset over the lease term. Now, such right may affect the conclusions of the contract as a whole, not satisfying the definitions of lease under HKFRS 16. So we need to consider impact of this right. So this is considered as other considerations before we concluding the contract as a lease contract as per HKFRS 16. Now, to begin with, as usual, we need to ensure that an identified asset exists in the contract. If not, the contract will not be conclude as a lease contract under HKFRS 16. Now, if an identified asset exists in the contract, we need to see if the supplier has substantive substitution rights. Now, how can we conclude that the supplier has such a substantive substitution right then? Well, there are conditions we need to fulfill. Two conditions need to be fulfilled by the supplier. Number one, A, the supplier has a practical ability to substitute alternative assets throughout the period of use, the lease term, and B, the suppliers would benefit economically from exercising of such rights to substitute the assets. Now, there are exceptions on these conditions here. The exception is, in fact, if the suppliers only have the right or an obligation to substitute the asset on or after either a particular date or occurrence of a specified event such as repairs, then in fact we can conclude that such substitution right is not substantive. Alright? And it is important that the lessor and the lessee have to evaluate such substitution rights, whether it is substantive or not, based on the facts and circumstances at contract inception. Contract inception means the date the two parties sign the contracts. So, back to this flow chart. If the supplier does have substantive substitution rights, right, then the next things we need to consider further is, would the suppliers be able to benefit from such the substitution rights? Now, if the answer for that is yes, then I'm afraid that the conclusion is that contract may not be able to satisfy the definitions of HKFRS 16 as lease contract. Okay. However, if in fact the suppliers may not be benefit from such substitution rights, then we need to consider whether the supplier has conveyed such right to control the use of an identified asset to the customers. Okay. If we can prove that the suppliers already obtain such a right to control the asset, then the conclusion is the contract would be considered as a lease contract in accordance with HKFRS 16. And of course, if it is not the case, then it would not be considered as a lease contract under HKFRS 16. Okay, back to the top. If we have an identified asset, but in fact we do not have, we do not see any substantive substitution right from a point of view of the supplier, and we can prove that the supplier has conveyed the right to control the use of an identified asset to the customers, which would be like back to the normal situations, then in fact the contract can be considered as a lease contract under HKFRS 16. Okay, now to reinforce our understanding of the definitions of a lease, let's go through the example together. So, the example will be as follows. Discuss whether the below contract contains a lease in accordance with HKFRS 16 leases. And this is the contract, and that has 3 points. I'll read down the 3 points first, okay? And then we will talk about the factors that we need to consider before we conclude this contract as a lease contract, okay? A contract between ABC Limited customers and the Flick carrier suppliers provides ABC with Flick delivery services with the use of 10 containers of a particular type for 5 years. The contract specifies the containers. And when the containers are not in use, they are kept at the supplier's premises. and the suppliers cannot deploy the containers to serve other customers. Finally, if a particular container needs to be repaired, supplier is required to substitute a container of the same type during the 5-year period. Okay, so we need to structure our answer using three factors that we have learned in the previous slides. Okay, and they are as follows. Number one, would there be an existence of an identified asset? Secondly, would there be any substantive substitution right? Can we say that in fact such substantive substitution right not exist? And finally, would the customers be able to control the assets? Okay, well, certainly by going through paragraph one, we know that we have 10 containers already stated in the contract. They are physically distinct and exclusive used by the customers. That is very clear. So we have a tick for that one. And we can see that there is a substitution rights exist. However, that substitution right may not be substantive. So let's look at it, right? As you can see, the supplier can substitute the containers during the 5-year period. So substitution rights exist. However, we won't say that right is substantive because the supplier can only substitute the container when repairs are needed. So it's a tick by saying that we don't have such substantive substitution right. And finally, obviously we can prove that the customers can consume all the economic value of containers directly through the Flick delivery service provided using the container. So after all, we can in fact almost have the conclusion clear enough to state that the contract between ABC and the Flick carrier is within the definitions of a lease contract in accordance with HKFRS 16. Even though the form of the contract is a service contract rather than a renting of an asset, in fact the conclusion would be the same. So therefore ABC would have to recognize the rights of use assets as well as the lease liability in its financial statements. Okay, so I hope you find the topic and the illustration interesting. Okay, and hope to see you sometime in the future in Part U. Thanks for watching.